Yes, Mr. Manning?
Yeah, little Dickie Bird whispered to me that you're trying to extend your sentence on purpose. Is that right?
Oh, I wouldn't do anything like that. That'd be real stupid, wouldn't it?
Bloody stupid, Benzie. Too stupid for me to have anything to do with. All right?
Right, Mr. Manning.
Listen, whatever your feelings, you and Kean are going to be together here until your trial. Now, the best thing you can do is stay out of any situation that could damage your case, right?
Won't be easy.
Well, you'll have Joey with you. You concentrate on him and leave everything else to the courts, all right?
Fellows want you dead.
And what do you want?
He's put it to me loud and clear. It's either you or me.
Oh, I don't see the point. You're not going to be in here for much longer.
But you never can tell, Mrs. M. When I was in here the last time, I got extra sentences all the time.
Well, if you stay out of trouble, Doreen, you won't have that worry, will you?
Doesn't seem I have much option. I love your frock.
Thank you, Doreen. Now just join the queue, will you?
I'm beginning to think that it's easier to get out of this place than it is to stay in it.
Well, if you'd rather sit on your own.
Oh, all right, don't be
silly. Anything wrong?
It's my daughter's 16th birthday. I'd like to be with her, that's all.
What do you reckon, Myra? About what?
I was just telling Dor here that she should tell this Hans creep that he doesn't turn her on or give in and marry her.
I told you before, Helen, I'm not the marrying kind. Not anymore, anyway, so just give it a rest, will you?
Hey, how do you reckon the women would react to forming a prisoner's union?
A union? What for?
Oh, better paying conditions, modern machinery, that sort of stuff.
And what if the department doesn't come to the party? Do we go on strike?
Well, we tried that before, and all we get is loss of privileges.
That's right. If you try and hold out, they just extend your sentence.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no. And my big mouth.
Happy birthday, Brett.
Oh, I thought you'd forgotten. Oh,
fat chance of that. You've been dropping hints for weeks. Well, come on, open it.
Oh, Alan, it's terrific. You shouldn't have spent that much.
How do you know how much it cost? I thought you might like to wear it tonight. You going out to celebrate?
No. I'm not.
Why not? I thought you planned out
It's been put off due to lack of interest. My friends have gone a bit cold on me since Mum went to prison.
Yeah. Been the same with me at work. I was up for that promotion, but now that all this has happened, I guess I'll be lucky to have a job at all. Still, it'll all blow over soon. We'll get by.
Yeah. Oh, I gotta go. Thanks again for the present. Well, listen, I might be a bit late this afternoon.
Oh, where are you going?
Might walk around a bit, have a look at a few shops.
You're not going to see Gloria, are you?
Maybe I'll drop in for a minute.
Listen, Brett, I know it's your day, but if you want to go out and visit someone, why don't you go and see Mum? It'd be nice for her, seeing as it's your birthday.
Yeah, I might do that. I've got sports period this afternoon. I could give it a miss.
Good. It'd mean a lot to her.
Okay, see you later.
Hey.
Thanks.
For a start, you will unload your equipment at the rear of the prison. I don't want this reception area cluttered up with this stuff.
Right. Right, Ian?
Right, Bert.
This is just bits and pieces. The rest of the stuff's out in the ute.
All your equipment will be itemised and accounted for when you leave.
Right. Right, Ian?
Oh, right, Bert.
Your equipment and vehicle will be inspected on arrival and departure, just to make sure that nothing's smuggled in or out. Is that clear?
You're going to be the lucky one to inspect my equipment?
Save the charm, Mr. Gibbs. We've got enough would-be clowns in this place.
Good morning.
Oh, good morning, Governor. These are the men to install the PA system.
Oh, good. How long do you think it'll take?
Oh, I'm not too sure. The plans I saw are in a bit of a mess.
Well, come through to my office and I'll show you what I had in mind. Miss Ferguson will brief you on security procedure.
She already has.
I haven't finished yet, Governor.
Oh.
Well, bring them through when you have, would you?
Yes, Governor. One more thing. There will be no contact whatsoever with any of the women prisoners. Right, Ian?
Right, but... Yeah, right.
Good. Now, if you sign the book, gentlemen, I shall take you through.
Hey, your card's right and you can have it, right?
Wrong.
Mrs. Powell?
Yes?
I'm Detective Birmingham. This is Detective Mears. Could we have a few words with you?
Is this concerning my family?
Well, indirectly, yes.
I thought Inspector Clark was handling the case.
Yes, he is, but we're on the case too.
I see.
We understand how you must be feeling, Mrs. Powell, so we'll keep this as short as possible.
Thank you.
Naturally, we're following the line that the bomb was meant for Rick Manning and not for your family. Oh,
that is fairly obvious.
Would you have any idea of anyone who might want to... kill Manning?
No, I wouldn't. I only work with him, so why don't you ask him?
Do you know of any association between Manning and Senior Detective Eddie Stevens?
Eddie Stevens?
Yes, do you know if they've seen each other lately?
No, I don't know whether they've seen each other lately. What has this got to do with anything?
We're pretty sure that Rick Manning is getting himself involved in things that are none of his business. Very dangerous things.
This is really unofficial, Mrs. Powell. But as a friend, it might be wise to warn him, don't you think? It might stop any more innocent people from getting hurt.
Thanks for your time, Mrs. Powell. We'll see ourselves out.
Don't just stand there. Give him a hand.
Driver,
okay? G'day, Ron. No, I'm afraid he's dead.
Any suspicious circumstances?
No, just another straightforward accident. Won't know until the car's been examined, of course, but it looks like brake failure to me.
Any identification?
Yeah, but it's not for print yet. Not until it's cleared. It's one of our boys. Stevens. Senior Detective Eddie Stevens.
Colin, you haven't been rostered back on duty yet, have you?
I just wanted to see if these fitted.
Yes, they're quite smart, aren't they?
Do you have a minute?
Yes, of course. I'd like a coffee?
No, thank you. I'd like to come back. If that's all right with you.
Well, I don't know. I mean,
I
don't
know
you think
we've had our problems, but I'm going mad hanging around Meg's flat with nothing to do. Look, if you don't want me working back here, then please could you just say so, because I'll have to look for something else.
Colin, please. All I'm worried about is whether you're well enough, that's all.
Couldn't I come back part-time, just a few hours a day? I'd be all right. I'd rather...
All right, then. I'll have you rostered on tomorrow. Is that all right?
Yeah, that's fine. Thank you.
Good. Sure you won't have one?
No, thanks.
Colin, how are you?
A lot better, thank you.
Good.
By the way, I had a visit from two detectives this morning. They appear to be rather worried about you.
Oh, what were their names?
Birmingham was one of them, I think.
What did they want?
They seem to think that you need some good advice about minding your own business, whatever that means.
And what did you tell them?
Oh, what could I tell them? I didn't know where you were or what you were up to.
Look, if they come back...
Hopefully they're not going to come back. You see, unless they found out who planted that bomb, I just don't want to know.
All right, Rick. You're late.
Yes, I'm sorry about that, Governor. I got held up.
And I want some answers. I've just had instructions from the department that you're to stay overnight here at Wentworth until further notice. Now, just what exactly is going on?
Onions, Cass, you're that slow. And you two, smarten it up. Oh, for God's sake, Doreen, stop the silly nonsense and get on with your work. I want to cook these potatoes for tonight, not next week.
I can't, Mrs. O'Regan. See, I'm going to sit down tonight.
Well, do it in your own time. I've got to get lunch ready.
Oh, Rick, I'm starving.
I'm going to shout for three, and if you're not up by then, I'm going to report you.
Oh, gosh, you wouldn't, would you?
All right. One, two...
Burns.
What the hell do you think you're doing? Get off there.
Oh, yeah. Right up.
Says she's on a sit-down strike.
Oh, does she? Well, Burns, you've just earned yourself a charge and you've lost your buy-up privileges. You happy?
Not bad, Miss Ferguson. You just stick around. I'm only just warming up.
Nice enough, did it?
Something wrong, Mitchell?
No, Miss Ferguson. I just wanted to go to the loo.
Well, go.
Yeah.
Come on, Burns, get up.
I can't, Miss Ferguson. See, I can't have a sit-down strike while I'm standing up.
You refuse?
Well, I don't want to cause any trouble.
Right, Burns. Stupid girl.
Oh, jeez, Dor. Thought you wasn't going to upset Miss Ferguson.
Yeah, well, what's it matter, Cass, as long as I get extra time.
G'day, sexy.
Eat your heart out, darling. Hey, what happened to your hair? Someone give you a fright?
What are you talking about? There's nothing wrong with it. What do you think, Mr. Manning?
Ah, a bit too far out for me too, Bobby.
Jeez, well, you lot wouldn't know anyway.
Better get a move on.
Manning, I have your assistance in the kitchen for a moment.
Here, right. You fellas be okay?
We'll be as soon as she leaves. Right, Bert? Right, Ann.
All right, Burns, this is your last chance. Either you get up now or we forcibly remove you.
Would you like me to get a forklift from the doctor's first?
Shut up, smart, and get on with your work. Thank you, Mr. Manning.
Still trying on, are we, Grins?
Oh. Oh, my God, there's a lunch bell. You get outside to start serving, quick.
Oh, that time. I'm starved.
You think you're going?
Oh, the lunch, Miss Ferguson, all this sitting around's made me real hungry.
Oh, I don't care if you starve. You're going straight to the governor.
You wouldn't do that, would you? She might send me up in front of the VJ and I might cop an extra sentence.
I would say that was a certainty. Burns, now get moving.
Birthday, love. I'd love to be with you. Maybe she'll come up and visit you after school, eh?
Oh, okay.
You've got to give up these escape attempts of yours, Bryant. They're taking their toll on you.
Sit on it, Stevens.
Oh, hi,
girls.
G'day, stranger. Hi. How are you feeling?
Oh, a bit weak, but don't spread that around. Listen, where's Phyllis? I'm going to squat us all, that bitch.
Oh, now take it easy. She was assigned the workshop this morning. She'll be on the second sitting.
Yeah, you get your strength back before you tackle her.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Go on, Jude.
Oh, thanks.
Hey, Jude, it's good to see you back.
Thanks. How's Minnie?
Oh, Jude, they transferred her to B block.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Well, I suppose that was to be expected.
Yeah, I suppose.
Still, she'll be a lot better off than we are if Phyllis sticks to that kidnapping charge. We're going to have a talk about that, Cass.
Right.
Well, Burns, what do you have to say for yourself?
It's all true, Mrs. Reynolds.
And you say the reason for all this was to demand more money, better conditions?
Yeah, that's it, and more modern equipment.
Well, since you're so fond of the floor,
You can go on cleaning duties until further notice. And you'll also lose your buyout privileges.
Yeah. What else?
That'll be all for the moment. Take her back, Miss Ferguson.
You mean that's it?
What's the matter with you, Burns? Would you rather go to solitary?
No. But what I mean is, when I was in here before, I used to do things nowhere near as bad as this and get a lot heavier punishment. They used to send me up in front of the VJ and everything.
I must say I'm inclined to agree with her, Governor.
I have no intention of keeping prisoners here any longer than necessary, especially for such stupid, childish behaviour. I've given my decision. Now, would you please take her back, Miss Ferguson?
Never mind, Miss Ferguson, but thanks for trying anyway.
Come here, Burns.
Will you get out of the way and get on with your work? It's almost time to start getting dinner ready. And look at the place, it's like a star.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. O'Regan. I want to see how they connect that speaker.
Oh, speakers and workmen and guards and men and females sitting in the middle of the floor. I don't know what's happening to get the work done.
So this is where you hang out in your spare time, eh?
Hello, Bert. Yeah, this is what I call my country retreat.
Go on, Bert. Remember the rules. No fraternising.
Never touched them.
Oh, sorry. I done the dining room.
Not you again. Get out.
I've got to do the floor.
Oh, no, you can't, because there's people walking all over it.
Well, I got the orders, and I'm in enough strife as it is already.
I'm going to kill her.
It's good of you to come, love. Thanks.
Didn't you expect me to?
Oh, I didn't know if you'd want to. Sorry I didn't get you a present.
That's all right. I didn't really expect one. I mean, I knew that you wouldn't have a chance.
Yeah. We haven't had a buy-up since I've been in.
Alan bought me a terrific new blouse.
Oh, good on him. Good old Alan, eh? Kay, love, listen to him. He'll see that you're all right.
Mum, I'm 16 now. I can look after myself.
I know that, love, but he's a bit older. He's had a bit more experience.
What's age got to do with it? Anyway, Alan's a real wimp. Gloria reckons he's a real mamby-pamby. I think she's right.
Gloria? You haven't been hanging around with that bitch, have you?
Sometimes. And why shouldn't I?
Kay, I told you to stay away from her.
She's the only real friend I've got left. All my other friends have deserted me since they heard what happened. I'm not even celebrating my birthday because nobody will go out with me. I want to leave now.
Okay, love, I'm sorry about your friends, but please, stay away from Gloria. She'll ruin you.
No, you've already done that. Mrs. Morris, could you take me back, please?
Of course. I'll send someone out for you, Myra.
Come on.
Afternoon off too.
Yes, I suppose I have.
Well, seeing we've both got plenty of time. Would you like another drink?
All right, thank you.
What are you drinking?
I started off with vodka and orange, but white wine would be fine, thanks.
I always stick to vodka myself. The clients can't smell it on you. Neither can the boss.
Oh, well, vodka it is. Wouldn't want to offend anyone, would I?
Tim, two more scribblers. Listen, seeing that we both got a lot of time to spare, why don't we spend the afternoon together? Maybe later on, go and have some dinner or make a real night of it.
No, thank you. I have to get home and cook dinner. No, I don't, do I? Not anymore. I'm sorry, what I mean is I have to meet someone this afternoon.
Yeah, well, fair enough. We'll see you around.
Thanks for the drink.
Pleasure.
Good
I see. When was it? How did it happen? Yes, I will. Is there anything else I can tell her? No, I suppose not. All right, Inspector, thank you for calling. Goodbye.
Some papers for you.
Oh, thank you. Meg, how's Stephen's been since her sessions with Dr. Weissman?
Well, it's hard to say, but she seems a lot better.
Let's hope she is. Would you bring her to see me, please?
Somewhere between Euroa and Benalla.
Yeah. God, it was a cold trip home, but it was worth it.
While the cat's away, eh? Come on, let's get back to it.
Not a good you are. You're supposed to be keeping an eye on these hoodlums.
Can't ignore the court of nature, Mrs. A.
You were gone so long, I thought you'd been called to go off.
Pick these up and receive some mail. One for Mitchell, one for Parker.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Manning. Ah, oh, to stand the man, Mr. Dobson.
Hey. It's not going to read you.
No, I'll look at it later. Hey, Cass, who's stand the man, Mr. Dobson?
Ah, that was an officer we had here for a bit. He was a beaut old fella. He had a crook ticker, but...
Listen, this business about you eating here. You have to put up with the same food as the women get. I can't be expected to put on special breakfasts and things. I simply haven't got the time.
Now, look, whatever you can manage will be fine, Mrs. A.
Sit down, Stevens.
I'll wait outside.
No, Mrs. Moss, I'd like you to stay.
This has nothing to do with the Dr. Weissman report, has it? Because, as you know, I'm perfectly
all right now. No, this has nothing to do with Dr. Weissman, I'm afraid. It's about your husband.
Eddie, what's he done?
I'm afraid he's been involved in an accident. His car was found at the bottom of a cliff. He was killed instantly. I'm very sorry.
Was he alone?
Yes.
Any suspicious circumstances?
No, not that I was told.
No. It wouldn't be, would there?
I don't think there was a lot of love lost between Stevens and her husband. Well, not on her side anyway. But she came close to having a nervous breakdown not long ago, and I don't think she should be on her own.
You said it was an accident?
Yes. Don't know how she'll take it. She doesn't give out much.
Why me?
I think you're the only one that's come close to her. I thought she might talk to you.
Story of my life. Listening to other people's problems. If I'd done a little less of it, I mightn't be in here now.
You don't have to, you know.
I'll give it a try.
Thanks.
How are you feeling?
I'm not feeling anything in particular.
I heard about your husband.
Yeah, risky work being a policeman.
It was an accident.
Was it?
What else?
Cops gather a lot of enemies along the way.
Any ideas?
Maybe.
Well, for what it's worth, I'm sorry.
Thank you. I owe you. I haven't forgotten. But spare me the sympathy, because I don't need it.
I think I've had enough.
My head's going round.
Hey, come on, honey. It's your birthday. If you have to have a reason for drinking bubbly, I don't.
That's so funny.
Oh, I don't know. It's... feel good, that's all.
Hi.
Come and join us. We've just started.
What's up, Al?
Oh, nothing. I'm okay.
Did something happen at work?
No big deal.
You didn't get the new job, did you?
Didn't even keep the old one.
You got fired.
Worse. They shoved me into a lousy junior clerk's job.
I'm sorry, Al.
Ah, tell them to stick it. Works for the birds anyway. Come on, have a drink. It's your little sister's birthday.
Yeah, and I remember something else too. We don't need you around here.
Just trying to cheer the kid up. Nobody else around here seems to be doing much about it.
I can take care of her. Now get out, Gloria.
I was invited by the birthday girl. We're mates, aren't we, honey?
I said get out.
Oh, come on, Al, don't get heavy. I get all the lecturing I need from Mum.
Did you go and see her?
Yeah, number one mistake of the day.
Why, what happened?
What always happens. She said happy birthday and then started to yell. Anyway, I don't want to talk about it.
Okay, you finished your drink, now pack it in.
I'm not going anywhere. Better tell him, honey.
She's got nowhere else to go. I said she could stay here for a while.
Are you off your tree?
Oh, come on, Al. After dear old Bill had his little accident, the landlord let me stay on for a while. I didn't come across, so he kicked me out for keeps.
This is Mum's house, and there's no way you're going to be staying
here. Oh, give us a break, Al. Your dad was real happy with me. Kay knows that, don't you, honey? Now, how do you reckon he'd feel if he could hear you talking to me like that, trying to kick me out into the gutter?
Well, he's not here, is he? And I don't feel a thing.
Well, I do, and I say she stays.
You're drunk, Kay.
And you're lousing up my birthday.
Yeah, so why don't you just go and play with some of your pansy mates and leave us alone? We're having a party tonight, aren't we, sweetie? Just a few intimate friends who know how to have a good time. But I don't really think it'll be your scene. Bit grown up for you, honey.
Listen, you don't need her sort of friends.
We're not getting that many invites from our so-called friends, are we?
Kate, listen to me.
Shut up, Alan, just shut up. I told you, I don't need any more lectures. If you don't like it, then drop off. Maybe we ought to give the party a miss.
No way! Hey! How often do you turn 16? Why don't we make a couple more phone calls? I know some guys who will really turn it on. Come on, what do you say?
Okay, why not?
Well, go on, go and make yourself all beautiful.
Manning, you want a hand?
Yeah, I wouldn't mind. Cass, just pull the table up this way.
Oh, I wouldn't push my luck if I were you. Cass isn't very fond of you.
With the rap she's up on, she wouldn't be gay.
Don't you bet on it. Minnie's not around anymore to calm her down. And I would certainly never protect a weasel like you.
Weasel, eh? I think the name suits her.
It does, isn't it?
Thank you, Cass.
All right, Mr. Manning.
Where's Stevens?
Oh, in a door.
Yeah, she's filing her nails, so I'd be careful if I were you. Bryant.
Bryant, this is Webster. Show the ropes, will you?
Oh, sure.
Hi. I'm Judy Bryant.
Sarah.
How are you, Sarah? Sarah, this is Cass and
Sarah.
Myra.
Hi. You don't look like you got much sleep last night.
Oh, couldn't. They say I murdered someone, but I didn't.
Webster, the governor's given permission for your baby to be brought in, and then you'll be transferred to maternity.
Thank you, Miss Ferguson.
I'd keep me kid away from Bryant if I were you. She's up on her kidnap charge right now.
Oh, why don't you shut up, eh, Phyllis? Just shut up.
Leave her alone. That is exactly what she wants.
Hey, Sarah, what's going on? Didn't you tell them what really happened?
What's there to tell? They traced me through the coat I lent you, found the money you planted in the bassinet, and my fingerprints all over the knife. I'm up on a murder charge, thanks to you.
Look, it'll be all right. We can prove it was an accident. I'll tell them you didn't know about the money or any of it.
Just stay away, Reb. You've done enough.
Well, well, well. Looks like you did a good job on her, too.
I think someone should do a job on you, Reb.
Oh, yes.
Phyllis? Ah, forget it. When they've finished with you, I'm going to punch your head in. Stupid bitch, I didn't dump you. It was Kevin.
You heavy me, you've really had it. So, I'll do a deal. You lay off the heavy stuff, I'll tell the gov what really happened.
And if we don't?
I'll lie my bloody head off, and you and Bryant will be on the kidnap rap.
Well, where does that leave you, weasel?
Yeah, got any ideas about that, smartass?
Back off, all here. Anything happens to me, they'll know right where to point the bone. So one way or the other, I'd say you're all stuffed. Right?
Do you think Ferguson will send flowers to her at his funeral?
What are you talking about?
Well, he warned her off, told her not to touch me. You'd think she'd want to thank whoever it was who got him out of the way.
It was an accident.
Really? But you still think he was on the take?
Well, you gave me the tip-off, remember?
It's funny, isn't it? Eddie was such a good driver, yet suddenly he drives over a cliff. Maybe somebody pushed him. Maybe it was the fellows. But then why would they want to do that? After all, he was working for them. Now, it had to be somebody that knew something else. Tell me, how far would you go to get even with the guys that killed your girlfriend, Mr. Manning?
You're off your brain.
Not according to the shrink. Now, what was it you said to me last time? Find out the truth, no matter what it costs.
You're not making sense, Stevens.
The question is, did he fall or was he pushed? Now, I'd say if you thought you could get even with those guys for your girlfriend, you could become very pushy, Mr. Manning.
What are you doing here, Hunt?
I'm just going for me fags.
Things getting a bit much for you in the rec room, are they?
Frightening those creeps.
Copping it from both sides now that Kean's back, eh?
Bitch. She's got him over a barrel. If she comes clean, they're off the hook.
You know, Hunt, maybe you need a little protection. I mean, Parker can get very ugly when she decides to take things into her own hands. Things getting a bit lonely in that cell on your own, are they?
Yeah.
Maybe it's time we had another cell shuffle. Right, you just leave it with me, Hunt. But remember, one word of this, and I'll deal with you. And you know that I can make Parker look like a beginner.
All right, ladies, can I have a bit of quiet, please?
Quiet! That's better. Now, there are going to be a couple of changes around here.
I'll bet. Where am I going?
Oh, you're not moving, Desmond, so you might as well settle in. In fact, I'd say you're going to be with us for quite a long time. Hope you don't mind.
Nice to feel wanted.
Kean will share with Hunt.
Why?
Oh, I thought you'd welcome that change, Bryant. Kean's hardly your type, is she? Webster can share with you till she goes to maternity. Okay, that's it. Move out.
You don't mind, do you? I don't want to be on my own.
Sorry, of course I don't. Anyway, you're going to get your baby back soon, aren't you?
Huh? Hey, Mr. Manning, if we hooked up a cassette player to them speakers, we could have music going through the whole prison, eh?
Yeah, good idea, Kat.
Yeah.
You like music, do you?
Oh, yeah. I rigged up some speakers in our chook house on the farm. I taught the chooks a twist.
See, I tell you, you're wasted in the kitchen with the laundry and stuff. We should try and get your osset into the workshop or something.
Oh, well, I like cooking too.
Yeah. Mm. Bet you can cook up a storm too, most country girls can. Anyway, I'll see you in the morning, Kath.
Righto, Mr. Manning.
How come you didn't yell getting chucked in here with me?
What's the point? What the freak says goes.
What's she playing at?
I don't know. Maybe she thinks we've got things to talk about.
She knows you ate my guts.
Hey, well, why don't we let her go on thinking that, eh? Could work out okay for both of us.
It's good to be home.
Well, that is very good timing. Should be boiling in a minute. Was it a bad day?
Oh, about average. How was yours?
I managed to fill in the time. I bought some odds and ends at the supermarket.
Oh, Colette,
yes, I know. You told me not to worry, but I can hardly stay here and let you pay for everything, can I?
Well, if it makes you feel better. Did you have some lunch?
Yes, I had a counter lunch at the pub. Thought the change of scene would do me good. Would you like a drink with your coffee?
No, thanks. I've got a bit of a headache, actually. I'll just have the coffee.
I thought it was time I contributed to the bar, too.
Oh, there's no need for that. Look, I think I'll have a shower first, freshen up a little.
Oh, well, I'll have your coffee ready.
You know, you're real lucky he didn't come with us. He had no intention of sharing that dough with anyone, including me. I mean, I thought we could handle him between us. Split the 50,000 two ways.
What happened?
Kevin's dead. Cops have got the cash.
Dead? How?
In an accident.
What are you going to do about Bryant and Parker?
They need me. They're too smart to do anything until I clear them.
Yeah. And if you do, I've had it. You're forgetting something, though, aren't you? The freak owes you one. She's not going to forget what you did to her old man.
So?
So? I'll handle her for you. I know how the bitch operates.
Suddenly you're going to do me a favour?
I'll make a deal with you. You tell him Bryant had the gun and you can forget about the freak. I'll fix her.
What's in it for you? Still get the kidnapper, eh?
Look, I know there's no way I'm going to get out of this hole, but I want to see Parker and Bryant go up the river on this one. It's their fault I'm back in here and I want to see the bastards pay.
I couldn't give a damn what happens to them. You sure you can handle the freak?
No worries.
Okay. Bryant had the gun. Parker grabbed the kid.
All right, party's
while on. While their album covers.
Hey, now what's going on?
I'd like to know, miss. Mind telling me who this
boy is? Don't want any bloody coppers around here.
You should have thought of that earlier, miss, before you started breaking the law. And you've just added assault to your charge. Okay, we'll collect the stuff and get them all down to the station. Better call for another car, yeah, Sid. Right.
Hey, come on. I mean, this has got nothing to do with my sister. She lives here.
Sorry, Mr. Desmond. It's gone further than just a rowdy party. This is cocaine. They're all being charged.
Hello.
It's Eddie. You saw the newspaper? Worked like a dream.
Yeah. Now, look, Birmingham and Mears have moved in on the Powell case. They've been asking questions about me. I think they know I was in the setup.
See, I said I would stay away from them too, but if they go near her again...
And don't panic. I'm ready to nail both of them.
Where are you?
It's better you didn't know. But I'm moving in, so you just sit tight.
Yeah, well, take care.
Likewise.
You will have some breakfast, won't you?
Yeah, of course.
You sure you're up to going to work today?
I feel fine. I didn't sleep well last night. I've just got a bit of a headache.
You'd be much better off with something from the doctor.
But I'll see. Wonder if there's any truth in the old story of a hair of the dog to fix a headache.
Wouldn't think so.
Well, I will have a shower, and then I promise I will cook myself a proper breakfast.
Good. You don't mind fixing stuff for me, do you? Oh, and that bread you bought yesterday was absolutely delicious. I'll see you there.
Bye-bye.
You should have let Cass do that, Mr. Manning. She'd have fixed it.
Oh, of course she could have. Gotta look after the job, eh, don't
I? Well, she's built like an ox. She might as well act like one.
I'm not an ox.
Two cellmates are very chummy this morning.
Yes, I noticed.
How'd you get on with Webster last night? Did she come across or what?
Can it?
What's it to you? Just leave her out.
There you go, Cass. Let me know if you have any more trouble.
Righto, Mr. Manning, looks like you fixed it, but...
Yeah.
Probably buggered it up so he'd come running. It's pathetic the way she sucks up.
Always a pleasure to help a lady.
And he's that far up himself, it's a wonder he can walk straight.
There'll be a few people around here with that problem very soon.
Myra, got a visitor.
Oh, a bit early, isn't it?
Well, the governor's given the okay. It's your son.
Oh, great.
Oh. Take over, would you?
Yeah, sure, love.
Taking orders from Desmond now, are you, Jude?
Hello, love. You're early. There's nothing wrong, is there?
It's okay, Mum. Just been arrested and it was my fault.
What are you talking about?
Gloria threw a party for it. Invited along some creeps she knows. I tried to throw them out, but no go. I didn't know they were using dope. I called the cops. I'm sorry, Mum.
What happened to Kay?
She got a warning and a fine. It's okay, I fixed it. She's all right, apart from a king-sized hangover. Made a mess of it, didn't I? But I got scared for her.
Don't worry, Alan. She loves you. She'll come good. Oh, if only I could get out of this place and talk to her properly. And get my hands on that bitch, Gloria. What happened to her?
They're all charged. I don't know. I just got Kay out of there fast.
Oh, God, I'd like to get my hands on that slut.
Your name is Gloria Jean Payne, is that correct?
What do you want? A date?
Just answer the questions and watch your language. Your name is Gloria Jean Payne?
Yes.
You're charged with possession of illegal drugs, causing a public nuisance, assaulting a police officer and using abusive language. You have been sentenced to 6 weeks imprisonment, is that correct?
Big deal.
Just watch it, Payne. Dope peddlers aren't too popular in here, with the women or the officers.
Right, just so now, Helen, I'll take you through to the gate.
Well, well, well. Fancy seeing you here. Come to check up that they locked the
door. Right, come on. Let's go.
Hey, you can't put me in here. His mother hates my guts.
Cut the chatter, Payne.
Listen, I tell you, she'll do me. You got to send me somewhere else.
Listen, Payne. You can't pick and choose your company in here. But don't worry. It's my job to protect you. So you've got nothing to worry about, have you? Thanks, Officer Ward. I'll take over here. Desmond? Payne here has just been inducted. I'd like you to show her the ropes.
Don't you leave me with her. She'll kill me.
Don't be hysterical.
Listen, she did her old man and she'll do the same to me.
I don't like being clutched, Payne. Okay, Desmond? You can take over. Oh, I'll take over.
You leave me alone, or I'll scream.
You won't have time.
Oh! Oh!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes.